Hello, lovely learners. Today I'm going to show you how to use the at-home artifact template, okay? So this is for the things that you have been doing at home that are backpack worthy. Yes, you have been doing things at home for sure. So if you look at the second slide, actually it's going to be our first slide. I'll move it to our first slide. There are going to be this video, of course, and then here are some examples. So you might be a productive collaborator. So think about things that you have done at home. And when you think, oh, I do this, then I want you to go to the next slide and fill that out. So let's look first at productive collaborator. So if any of these things are like, I've done that, perfect, go fill it out. So have you been a productive collaborator? Some examples could be things like helping with snack, helping with the dishes, maybe you helped with siblings, taking care of siblings. Maybe you helped make your bed or helped clean a room, maybe your room or a room. So if you feel like any of those things are true to you, go on over and fill out this form, okay? Now, if you don't, keep reading. So let's go down here to this one, yellow. Effective communicator. So think about, have you talked about or communicated a dislike? Maybe you didn't like some way somebody was doing something. Maybe a sibling was being too noisy and you needed it to be quieter. Or have you had to request a want or a need? I really wanted that cookie from the store and I had to talk to my grown-up about why we should get that, okay? That would be communicating. This can be in any type of way. So maybe it's verbal, but it might also be signing or approximation, gestures, or even if you have written it, that's the type of communication. So any type of communication works there. If you feel like you have done that while being at home, go on over and fill it out for effective communicator. Let's look at our next one, global, the blue up here at the top, globally and culturally competent citizen. So some examples of things that would be globally and culturally competent and would make you a globally and culturally competent citizen would be maybe you learned a new tradition. I know we had the holidays, so maybe you learned a new tradition. Maybe you tried a new food. Or maybe you attended a protest or a rally, okay? So these things are all things that would be considered globally and culturally competent. And you could add, if one of those things or if something else, you know, sparks your memory, then head on over and fill it out for globally and culturally competent citizen. Notice how the pictures match, right, to help you, and the words are also underneath. If none of these, you know, ring a bell for you, let's look at prepared and resilient learner. So if you are a prepared and resilient learner, maybe you learned a new instrument while you've been at home or you're working on it, right? Maybe you've been learning how to cook or learning any new skill at all. Maybe learn how to play basketball, learning how to use your computer better, or you fix something that was broken. Those things are all things that show that you're a prepared and resilient learner. So if you've done any of those things or other things that you think show prepared and resilient learner, go on over and fill it out for prepared and resilient learner. Our last skill down here at the bottom with the light bulb is emerging innovator. Emerging innovator, so inventing or creating things. So think about maybe you've created something with blocks or Legos. I know a lot of you guys have made things for Ms. Schmidt, but maybe you've made something else for fun. Maybe you've created a world or something on Minecraft. I know a lot of you guys like Minecraft, or you've built anything. You built something, you created something, then this would be emerging innovator. So if you feel like that's you, head on over and fill it out for emerging innovator. So now that I've given you some examples, let's look at how to actually fill the template out. So once you know, okay, yeah, I definitely have helped my grandma do the dishes a lot. And that, if I look at my examples, would fall under helping with the dishes, helping with things, that would be productive collaborator. So I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna circle productive collaborator. So click and hold down on the click and drag over to productive collaborator, okay? Then down below, describe what you did. So tell us what you did. I helped my grandma do the dishes. All right. And then how does that show your skill? How does that show that you're a productive collaborator? I mean, collaborating is working together. Because, so then you could click an add here. How does that show your skill? We worked together and helped each other without arguing. And if you can't see that, you know, you can always make the font bigger or kind of move it around. There you go. Oops, I forgot my period. And the last piece is optional, but we would love for you to insert a picture or a video right here on the picture frame. You can get a grown-up's help to do that, or you can just do insert. And then if you're going to do a picture, it would be image from your computer, or you could even take a picture right then, right? Oh, Grandma, let's get a picture of us doing dishes again. So click on that camera and run over and work on the dishes and snap a picture while you're doing it. And then once you do that, it'll ask you to insert it, and it'll just insert it right here. If you're wanting to do a video, like, it's a little trickier, but you're still going to go insert and video and upload it, either if you've uploaded it to YouTube or on your drive or on your device, okay? Good luck filling out your at-home artifact template. Once you have done that, send it on to your homeroom teacher, and they will help you get it on into your backpack, okay? Great job!